in Semarang, there is the, or the biggest. Absolutely massive here, but in this courtyard, if it's packed and full, it can fit 15,000 people. And inside the main building straight ahead, you can fit 2,000 people. So these umbrellas are here just to cover from rain and so on, because apparently it rains a lot in Semarang. I haven't seen it yet. Well, the dry season is coming to an end, but I haven't seen any rain here yet. But even in the dry season, according to Wikipedia, it rains quite a lot, so I guess I'm lucky a little bit.
See how shiny the floor is.
So the tower behind me where the restaurant is, it's 99 meters tall. And there's also a 23-room hotel in there. You can go up there, so I'm gonna go check it out, because it looks interesting. There's an observation deck at the top. You can take an elevator up there, as well as a museum. And a lot of things, a lot of numbers represent something. So 99 meters tall, it represents the 99 attributes of Allah. So everything is thought out really well here. I'm gonna go see if I can get up there.
Wait. Yeah, very little.
Ini langsung lantai paling atas, top tower, 19. Okay. Nanti di atas ada teropong. Kalau mau pakai paketnya koin seribuan.
They speak English? No.
Okay.
I'm very bad in Bahasa. Don't speak very well. Sorry. Yeah. That's okay. Museum is down?
Yes.
And restaurant?
And second
restaurant turn?
Restaurant closed.
Closed. Okay, I'm at the top of the viewing tower. Nice and bright here after being in a dark elevator. So apparently the lady who escorted me up on the elevator said that the restaurant is closed. So no more makanan here. And they have these viewing goggles, but they're also closed off. But you can see all the buildings in Semarang. little bit misty. What is there? What's up, girls? Up, girls. That's one of the entrances. I took the back entrance, I think. But being up here is an interesting perspective because usually when I'm up high on the mountains, you're not so close to the city, but this is literally in the middle. So these things are a thousand each if you want to view. You can see all the farmlands right next to the mosque. And some slums there as well. Tower, you have to be careful. All the air conditioning were cranked up to 32 degrees, so it's very, very hot in there. I would even go as far as saying it's cooler outside if you're in the shade. I think that place is off limits right now. You can see the doors are closed and nobody's walking around in there, so I'm not gonna go there. But it's pretty interesting how shiny these marble tiles are. It's almost like an ice skating rink. And there's the dome! So definitely worth a visit, even if you just come here to marvel at the engineering and construction. And by the way, I was reading about these tiles that the roofs are made of. They imitate the traditional Javanese roofs, and they also represent like a pathway to higher grounds, higher levels of consciousness. No, you can't go up there. You can only look but don't touch. You can only imagine the size of the mallet to smash that drum. And what sort of noise it makes. So the mosque is done. Tomorrow morning at 5 o'clock I will start my journey towards Karimunjawa, which is one of the tropical islands off of Semarang. But you need to go to a city called Jepara to take the fast ferry. That takes about 2 hours and then you're on the island. So I'm gonna stay there for a couple of days and then come back to Semarang, because there's still some places here that I didn't see. But because my hotel booking was finishing and I didn't want to book a couple of extra days, I decided to head straight off. It's a bit of a mess to get all the tickets organized, but you'll find a way if you want to. So the next time I see you guys is on a paradise island. What's up, boy?